The voyage of the Parker Solar Probe is about to begin. Its 7-year mission? To boldly go where no craft has gone before. To touch the sun. To seek out answers to questions like, why is the sun's corona so dang hot? Smaller and speedier than Starship's past, NASA's Parker Solar Probe is set to blast off from Cape Canaveral aboard a Delta IV Heavy rocket, the largest in NASA's arsenal. After clearing Earth's atmosphere, Parker will shed its rocket and get one last boost. Then spring-loaded gadgets that were stowed for launch emerge. Solar panels pop out and start charging. The cooling system revs up, and antennas and other instruments stretch out into space. 6 weeks after launch, Parker reaches Venus. It'll use Venus's gravity to slingshot itself toward the sun. Another 6 weeks later, Parker becomes the first spacecraft to enter the sun's outer atmosphere, or corona. The corona is actually hotter than the surface of the sun, but a pancake-shaped heat shield keeps all of Parker's gadgets a little above room temperature. Most of the spacecraft's solar panels also tuck behind the carbon composite shield to avoid melting. Traveling at high speeds will prevent Parker from getting pulled into the sun. As the probe surfs the sun's atmosphere, it'll gather important intel on solar radiation, electric fields, magnetic fields, and particles. The data could help explain what heats up the corona and how solar wind escapes the sun and accelerates through the solar system. Then Parker swoops back out to cold, dark space and transmits its data back to Earth. It'll do the same thing 23 more times, sweeping by the sun every 88 days. Venus will give the probe 6 more slingshot assists, and each time it will inch closer to the sun's surface. While Parker is close to the sun, it won't be able to radio home, so the probe will have to fly solo. Tiny solar sensors tell the craft to shimmy left or right when they're exposed to too much sun. Parts of Parker will get hit with 475 times the solar radiation that spacecraft experience in orbit around Earth. The probe's final 3 orbits will take it within 6.3 million kilometers of the sun's surface. That's 7 times closer than the current record holder, Helios 2, back in 1976. On its final orbit, Parker will also come in fast and furious at a top speed of 690,000 kilometers per hour, or 190 kilometers per second. It'll be the fastest human-made object in the solar system. At that speed, you can travel from New York to Tokyo in under a minute. So top that, Vin Diesel! The mission is set for 7 years, but it could go longer. Whenever Parker meets its end, it'll go out in a blaze of glory. Once the probe runs out of fuel, most of it will burn up in the very star it was sent to study. But not the heat shield. That giant carbon disk will continue to orbit the sun for millions of years.